We're back. Okay, so let's just, I want to get into this, like, or go through this relatively quickly in terms of, give me your first impressions, like one or two words. How are you feeling?
Boring. It was very, very boring. You know, I was coming in and I was expecting to be a little bit entertained. I would expect to have some more information about Xbox Series X, you know, like how they were supposed to have a gameplay reveal showing off the hardware of the new console while also going into some of the specs, going into some of the specifics about the video gaming console, going into why I should purchase this video gaming console. But instead of coming out of this conference or this of this reveal, whatever you want to call it, wanting to buy this console, I now am like, I'll wait. I'll hard pause on this console. The entire thing, the entire like Xbox Series X game reveal was like 27 minutes. And I was watching kind of some of the pre-show and then I watched the actual thing. And I was like, why? Why did they do this? Especially if they have something in July. I don't understand why they did it. I don't get why they did it. But if you haven't seen it, let me explain. So pretty much for about 27 plus minutes, they showed off a bunch of new entries for the console. Great. That's a great job from Microsoft. They did exactly what they needed to do and that the fans were asking them, begging them to do for years. Like, can we please have some new games? So they showed off the new games. The only issue is, in a conference, in a reveal where you're supposed to reveal a lot of gameplay, they didn't reveal any gameplay except for this new game that I actually kind of liked. I liked what I saw from this new game. It was called Bright Memory Infinite. That's what it's called. I have no idea what it is. Apparently, it's from, I think, one person. Like, one person in one dev team made this game.
What you just witnessed was Bright Memory Infinite from Playism, created from the ground up by a single individual at FYQD Studio in China.
It seemed like it was a demo. It seemed like it was incredibly scripted. And that's fine. That's what I expect from gameplay demos. They don't have to be perfect. They just have to show me why I should, like, be interested about your game. However, that was the longest gameplay demo that they had to show off. That was the most amount of gameplay that they had to show me as a viewer. And then some of the other gameplay demos that they showed off, and then some of the other trailers, because if I'm honest with you, they weren't gameplay demos, like how Cyberpunk 2077 had a bunch of gameplay to show off last year, and the year before that, Spider-Man had some gameplay to show off, The Witcher 3, God of War even had a lot of gameplay to show off. The issue with Microsoft is, in this press conference, is that they didn't have anything for me to watch, and worse yet, some of the gameplay that they showed off, some of the gameplay that I watched, especially the Madden 21 gameplay and Assassin's Creed Valhalla, it looked like it was either current gen or last gen hardware. It looked fucking terrible. And I asked Microsoft the question, and you know, maybe Microsoft has more gameplay to reveal, specifically, you know, some of the first party exclusives that everybody knows and loves, like Halo and Gears of War and stuff like that, and maybe some more hard-hitting games and stuff like that. But I was watching it and I was like, you know, there's new IPs, but I don't know what the new IPs are all about. I don't know what they do. I don't know what you're going to do in the game. There wasn't a lot of explanation. And then again, they didn't show off the hardware. They didn't show off the new console. I know what it looks like. I know that there have been some prototypes that have been sent out to people, but it wasn't like a full formal reveal. And that's what I wanted it to be. And that's what it wasn't. And then on top of that, the stuff that they did show, some of it I liked, some of it I didn't like. I can't look at the gameplay and be like, oh yeah, this gameplay looks interesting. Here are these things that I thought in the game that I was interesting, besides, again, Bright Memory Infinite, because most of the game demos, most of the trailers were like a minute long. So I can't really be like, oh yeah, you know, look at this gameplay mechanic. Look at this core mechanic. This is great. Blah, 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 blah. You know, the current things that I always do within my videos. However, there is a July event for the Xbox Series X for Microsoft. Maybe they'll have a better introduction for their new console. And you know what? I may be taking it a little bit too hard on Microsoft. I kind of just realized that because I do understand, you know, maybe they wanted to just show off some gameplay and show off some of the games that they have coming down the pipeline for the console. And this was just like a primer for what they have in store in July. By the way, I have no idea when in July because there is no release date for, or not release date, but there is no date for their next conference or big reveal or whatever they're gonna call it. It's still, I guess, in the works. but they have another shot. As much as I think that they didn't do a great job at showing off their new console and what it can do and some of the new games that are going to be on the new console and why people should be excited and interested in this console, they still do have another shot at it. I feel like they still haven't revealed the system sellers for the Xbox Series X. I really, really hope that it's not another third-party game that Sony has access to, because it's like, all right, you know, you have Madden, you have Cyberpunk, and they had Cyberpunk at the Xbox conference last year, but it's like Sony and PC is going to get Cyberpunk. Sony and PC are going to get Madden, and Madden looked horrible on the Xbox Series X. You shouldn't have put it on your conference because it looked terrible, but now they'll get another shot. I hope they do something interesting with it. I hope they do something better. I kind of hope Cyberpunk 2077 is there, even though Cyberpunk 2077 will have their own kind of conference in Night City Wire. I'm lukewarm now on the new Xbox console, and to be honest with you, that's not a good sign, because I kind of was lukewarm on the Xbox One when it was announced and then released all the way back, I think, in like 2013. This has been 24. Remember to like, comment, favorite, and subscribe for more. Until my next video, I hope you have a fantastic day, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.